Conway's long-awaited Shady debut is finally here. I think this album has the potential to legitimately be the best album on the Shady label. Let's get into it. Nah, these drums tough. Nah, this be different. That's the toughest rhyme scheme of the album so far. And the cartridges land, the stick was like a guitar in my hand, drumming like a part of a band. My dog was behind the wall with your man. I heard you got friendly. He started talking at the end. He really warmed up. Flick when I spit without using a pen. Dance with the devil, the death call. I'm out the buff with the slanted face, killer with bell balls. Call on block, get stuffed in the can or work off. Dang, that beat was amazing. That beat sounded like he got a body on it. That was a grimy beat. If you isolated the guitar, it really had like a groovy feel to it. It was like a submerged underwater but still groovy feel to it. But the way they put the synths and the drums on it, that beat sounded dangerous. That was a good beat. Conway's verse was solid. The last half of that verse was really good. He started getting into some dope rhyme schemes. He was just, you know, getting into his brag, swag, braggadocio on that first half. The rhyme schemes were there, but they got better as the verse progressed. I don't know what they were doing with Beans' mix. His voice came in there. That nigga came in there whispering. He had a light verse, but it was a gem in there with the slanted face killer. Conway should stick with that nickname. That's tough. But yeah, that was a solid song, man. I think Derringer was the star of that song. This man is really elevating with his production. He's always had that spooky sound, but he's just getting these beats more and more texture, playing with more and more sounds, getting more and more creative. That was tough. All right, this is Tear Gas with Wayne and Ross. The niggas say he gonna do something to me. How that sound? Anybody get out of bounds? Shots gonna come and knock him down. Probably. That opening rhyme scheme is tough. Catching to make people think you really was my nigga. Told my mama don't let them fuck niggas in my family. That modulation is different. Me and my jewels, so niggas know my life is beautiful. Illest to write it, all challenges are invited. The beat crying a little bit with the little vocal sample. Book of Conway, I'm far from my final chapter. Retired trapper, my idols wasn't no rappers. Not at all. Race to the top and I'm driving faster. Feeling to never see your kid again. And this a Russell Wilson type nigga raising your little man. Real shit. I know the feeling, ain't seen my son. The content is tough. Don't answer for me, so fucker, I'm in my feelings. Fuck, my brother just came home from doing time. I put a bankroll in his pocket cause I love to see him fly. DS on his neck, even if I gotta give him mine. And my bro don't owe me I just want to see him shine. Catch up. Oh, they got my boy singing. I feel like they justified, too terrified to testify. You get terrorized, that's that defined. Die second guy, body parts can't be specified. Set on fire, by his dinner work, he get identified. This bitch gotta come and verify. The revolution will be televised. I'm about to bench. Bro, what got into this nigga? Bro, what year is it? Nah, this nigga came in snapping. Watch, fuck on Zoom and let our friends watch that free dope, no cap, no syringe top. Killing pussy, the dick need teardrop. No cap, no syringe top. I'll be there in 10 tops, clip full like an inbox. Shoot you in your ear pods. I like to thank my brother. Hold on, I'm in danger. I'm in danger. You niggas slaughtered your daughter's attendance earnings. I'm in the cullin and calling shots, I'm the colonel. This rhyme scheme is pretty sick for Ross. I keep the drums and the guns just for the paranoia. Nah, that song's sick. The beat was tough, the vocal sample was fire, and then the modulation when it had the chord shift, you know, about 8 bars into the song, tough, and then it switched back to the original chord progression. Conway and Wayne lost their minds. Them niggas went off. Ross' verse was solid. I think his rhyme schemes were a lot better than they typically are in his songs. I think he stepped it up because, you know, he was on the track with Conway and then this Wayne who just been bodying everything in the past about two, three years. Conway's storytelling on this song was sick. It was disgusting, very vivid. And his rhyme schemes were fire while he was storytelling. Lil Wayne left Earth with his verse. It's hard to judge who was best out of those because Wayne's verse was a bar fest and lyrical gymnastic when it came to rhyme scheme complexity versus Conway's storytelling. But man, both of them niggas left their recency bias. I might slide it Wayne just a tad bit. That was a sick verse. It's going to be hard for any guest verse on this album to top this. And that's with me already hearing the Gun and Benny features. So two for two. This is Piano Love, which was the lead single for this album. I don't know what got into these producers. I guess Al heard the first two beats and was like, I took that personally. Hood nigga still eat the ramen noodles. That low cost that if I got it to you. Let's go. Mob, you violate that, I gotta shoot you. Send some rockets through you, hollow tips popping to you. Man, he's one of the best when it comes to just taking one rhyme scheme and using it for a large portion of the verse. It's like cipher like because he's taking this three syllable right here and he's already about six bars into it. And it rocking since niggas was rocking Fubu. I don't care what city you from. You still going. Whip it till my wrist bone hurting. Newspapers on the windows, no curtains. Fiends knocking, soul searching. That's tough. The realest bitch I ever had. I think it's my favorite chorus so far too. Bucket low like Ace Boogie. I re up 200 cash. Richest nigga into some bacon in the pot with some ice. The dope I cook lock up sneaker box with pants in the bag. You think this is too much? This is too much. Niggas getting smoked in broad day, and it's a shame. Don't matter if you was in front of the precinct, you getting stained. Ain't no respect in my hood unless you put in some pain. Keep face head, drive bys right in front of the daycare. We spray head pinch, that effing on the waist head. I've been gonna smack the black off one of you niggas, man. Playing with boy, Wesley Snipes shaking right now. He said, I slide the black off your gums. I'm telling you, man, the storytelling of this bit is so vivid. Hey, you might get PTSD from listening to it. This is grimy. I thought the first verse was sick enough, but then the Gun talk on that second verse, he didn't have anything that was crazy as far as like wordplay, no like double entendres, not too many double entendres, stuff like that, but just the level of like vividry. Vividry? Is that even a word? How vivid it was and how grimy it was. Like, we shooting in front of the daycare. You're talking about shooting somebody in front of the precinct. That's a tough verse. Both verses, first verse and second verse. The beat is just insane. Then I can see off rip. La Machina and From King to a God. It definitely had a lot of mainstream elements to it. This is straight from the Reject 2 playbook. This is for Conway's core fans, or at least that's how it seems so far. All right, this is Drumwork with Love the Genius and Jay Skees. You can say this about a lot of Griselda beats, but this really reminds me of a Mobb Deep beat. Overlook, now I'm the most noticed, hope it's noted, this how real niggas supposed to look. My verse is like tough a rhyme scheme about my life and the niggas I shot and all the dope I cook. Take it off. The pen is so crisp. On me, shots running down even if he had a broken foot. All the code be still sold it by the boatload of push. Pandemic got you niggas hurting. Ain't no shows the book. Nigga, ain't no fat to collect. We shot. That ain't funny, but it's funny. Feelings in your chest, just killing with your success. They gon' be sick when they vision your neck. Them pieces with the emerald sets. 180 for the ABs with the baguettes. Got bitches on. Let's go. Talk to him. I left the kitchen a mess. I twist my wrist and I stretch. My nigga, listen, I'm blessed. I'm Russell Wilson, how I wiggle through the rest. Nigga, pitching me stretch. Four syllable rhyme scheme going. My OG ain't teach me how to cook a brick. I taught myself. Now I'm jumping out the live Ferrari, go yard the belt. Man, Conway got to chill, man. He's going in. He had one of his craziest rhyme scheme and one of his most descriptive bars with when he was rapping about his chain. That's a solid verse, man. That's a really solid verse. That's better than solid. Where did I come from? But my life been so crazy, I'm startled by the conundrum. Cause I've been trying to make it since 90 something. As dumb young sent me back where I come from. Now that I'm here, I ain't going stupid, I'm going dumb dumb. I see where she was going with that rhyme scheme, the conundrum dumb dumb. Solid. Lie, they not surprised, it's always coming. Found a way like fuck it, make it nasty, put a thumb in. A city full of two strikes, but still get that price. Make it nasty, put a thumb in.
The fact I made it had rappers feeling invalidated. But breaking through for me was like the roads that went and cracked the pavement. I put in a label like it's
that's
black
fire. And see these writing. That's fire. The rhyme scheme and the bar itself was fire of that opening. Kicks, you ain't finding these Jordans. I hit the cellar. Bro, he's snapping. In front of him, like I was signing the artist. See, I just put a bullseye on my target. That's tough. That's fire. It's right on Bailey. Guns clapping, sounding like it made it. I rose from this shit. It's getting crazy. You see, we. Bro, Jay came out there and smoked that song. He easily, in my opinion, easily had the best verse on the song. And that's after a really good Conway verse. I mean, that's a Jay verse is, I think, is slightly behind. But it's up there with that Wayne verse, which was amazing in and of itself. Man, his rhyme schemes were fire from start to finish. He was getting to a lot of 4 and 5 syllable rhyme schemes, which, you know, when you get into the 5 syllables, that's you getting into MF Doom territory as far as your pen. But yeah, man, descriptive, vivid, the imagery was on point. Same thing could be said for Conway's verse. I think he was just a notch behind Jay with his verse. Love, she disappointed me a little bit because I think she's a fire artist. And I was really excited for her verse, but you know, she was just okay. The make it nasty, like putting a thumb in, that was a hilarious punchline. But overall, her verse was just okay. I think the beat here was dope. I don't think it was as explosive as the first 3 beats on the album. Definitely not explosive as Derringer's first beat. It was still solid. It provided that proper soundscape. Oh, this is Wild Chapters with T.I. and Novel. In a rose truck waiting for the light change. Thinking, damn, I came from the bottom. Look how my life changed. Man, I said this on Hit-Boy's last project with Nas. He's really good at taking a sound source and making it sound like something different. At first, I didn't catch that that was a vocal sample. I was trying to figure out what instrument that was, but it's vocals. That's dope. These drums are sick. I know I ain't perfect. I lied and I cheated. I told my girl I apologize. This time I mean it. Again, personal too. Come on. I had a son a little while after. And when he died, I know it was hard for you to smile after. While all that was going on, I had a child after. So how the fuck I'm supposed to be a proud rapper? That verse was not long at all, but it was just so much packed into it. Every bar just felt an emotional connection with every single one. He's peeling back layers of himself. Oh, and man, that was one of the main knocks I had for Conway with a lot of his earlier projects. Even though he had the pen in his earlier projects, I thought there was definitely room to go with both getting personal and with getting like really descriptive and really vivid. And he's like stepped it up with, I'll say, most of his projects since No One Mourns the Wicked. Let's keep going. Stoops and the benches, department project offenses. Shit, we out trying to get about the trenches. Elevate your comprehension, consolidate your vision. He came with the vocab. Understand that you wasn't meant to fit in. Remember, I ain't got no warrants to Florence, Italy, torn. Machine and the king from Bankhead. Tough. Man, that was a good verse by T.I. And it's just dope that these two are on a song together because, man, T.I., you know, he gets lumped in the trap rap category, but he did a lot for, you know, cult rap, even though, you know, you'll associate him more with trap and, like, Gucci and the South as opposed to, like, Pusha T and Clips' lane. But he did a lot for this lane that Conway is rapping in now. Conway and Griselda rapping in now. That's a good line. Tough song, man. Like I said, that beat is amazing. I think it did a perfect job of being a good canvas for them to have more of an emotional song, but still keeping the soundscape of the entire album as a whole. Conway and Novel's verse were super personal, super emotional. T.I.'s verse wasn't as emotional, but it was definitely descriptive. But I thought all three guys really brought it. All right, this is Guilty. Back with the Mac with extensions. Thinking about when they had me laying on my back in intensive. Clapped in my head and neck. That shit was inches from here. Doctor said the bullet too close to my voice box to try to get it out of. Can't touch when now I die. There's anything we can do about it.
Bell's palsy from damage to my nerves. No feeling in my legs. I took a bullet in the head, nigga. Focus on the lyrics. Don't focus on my appearance. You know you too pussy to go through it, so you fear it. You see the way that they quoting this shit hysterically. What you see is the dopest of any era machine. Like a lion.
Man, he's talking more about getting shot in this song than like his whole career combined. I mean, outside of The Cow, what song has he really talked about getting shot? Definitely not to this level of death. He might, you know, make a line about it and make a flip about it.
Underground, but still I'm a rich nigga. A few years ago, I was just on my dick, nigga. The moral of my story, I ain't switching my pitch, nigga.
I always thought that was a wild phrase.
Pen, no pad when I write these letters. I just recited off the top. That shit hype me better. We played with bricks since the fitted cap and white tee era. Ask Benny, ask West, had semis, had text, nigga.
Man, Conway on one. He is putting a lot of himself into this album, and it's coming off great, combined with the fact that he's not slacking at all when it comes to like the technical aspect of rapping. He's putting a lot of craft and care into each bar. This wasn't my favorite beat on the album, but I think the sample is solid, and you needed a beat like this for this song. You couldn't just do a regular spooky beat, or the song wouldn't have the same feel or emotions to it. All right, so this is Jungwoo Flick. This was the second single.
Take a big and make a quota with the baker soda. Pray to Jehovah, K with the shoulder strap, spray is over. Wait, hold up, if I say so, spray a roller, spray the fold up. Niggas gun fellas like Ray Liotta. Yeah. I need to see the money pile over. My shooter coming off the bench like Kyle Korver. Had the body for money, left with foul odor. Derringer compared to RZA. I'm compared to niggas that'll stab you in your face with a pair of scissors.
That's such a tough line. No, that's a tough line. That's such a good transition. Bodie James, you can't let them talk about Detroit like that, man.
That's Wayne Perry shit. Y'all niggas Wayne Brady's. Y'all pussy. I'm leaving with your daughter if you can't pay me. These OGs around me, real veterans.
These niggas is grind.
It take a lot for me to feel threatened. If it's time to clip you, we the ones to move. I got the call about it before I seen it on the news. Like brown interiors, the seats peanut butter too.
That's tough.
Everybody G till they get hit with a hawk. Hit with a hawk. The main line in the L and get hit with a fork. Had a clock.
Body show each pole, keep acting like you know what.
That's such an ignorant line. Hey, since the Hitler Wears Air Mess series is supposedly done, he can do Kim Jong Wears Own.
Machine gun in the summer, still wearing gloves. B.O.P. me in the mess hall with all my blood.
I thought that song was sick when they released it as a single a few weeks ago. The beat is just like, let me wipe the grime from the beat off me. The beat is disgusting. First time I heard it, I thought Conway's verse was excellent. I feel no different here. But I got a better appreciation for Benny and Gunn's verses here too. Benny had a bunch of fire punches in his verse. And then Westside Gunn's delivery was so fire. You know, he has charisma, so he'll say something funny in there. The wearing Dior feel like Kim Jong. That line is low-key stupid. But I love it. Yeah, man, that song's sick. That song's sick. This is Stress with Wallow 267. Nah, that drum different. That's B Butch and Derringer. That drum is different. It feels like something's dripping in the background too.
It's not only mine, got everybody's situations that I
that's
gotta
real.
Make better. And that shit take cheddar.
That shit
guess niggas think 10 million was shady beta. I tell them no, they talk down on me and try to play it. Guess they forgot about all the other shit that I gave them.
About all the other times.
Funny how that's they real. Could be so forgetful. Also, he took a cord and put his throat through that. I wish I had a chance to tell a nigga don't do that. Fuck off. Niggas don't understand. Depression is real. People stress too long after my cousin hung himself. I never told nobody, but I lost a son myself. Imagine being in the
yeah, he mentioned that.
And he looked just like you.
He mentioned that earlier. But I was like, man, I don't keep up with people's personal lives, so I didn't know that was public info or not. Man.
10 months old, I was abused. Kicked in the stomach, I swallowed like a balloon.
I was fucked up.
Zipper on my stomach, cause they split my liver. Well, not a day go by where I don't sip my liquor. Where I don't roll when it twist
God, dang.
Thought I was helping with the pain, but I'm just getting
nah, sick. That's crazy. That opening on that third verse was crazy.
burning this kush while I pace, crying in the mirror every time I look at my face.
Man, that's a dark song. That's a dark, emotional, but still excellent song. I don't know how Griselda got the steroids series, so they got Reject on steroids, Hitler on steroids, and Butcher on steroids. Man, this album here is like the cow on steroids. Man, this is just really emotional, really dark. It's so much stuff that he was talking about, the alcoholism. The thing that hit the most with the alcoholism was the fact that he talked about being abused when he was 10 months old and like his liver getting split, and then the fact that he's drinking. So if that beat wasn't that beat, if that was like a darker, moodier beat, like I probably would not just take a break. I come back to this album later. Yeah, that song takes a lot out of you emotionally. That's a sick song, though. This is so much more.
Eyes is the windows to the soul of a man. I look at you and see you weak, so I know where you stand.
That sample is sick.
Ain't nobody in the way of my goal and my plan to say I'm your bro, I'm your man. I know they won't understand.
The way this mix has that fuzzy feel to it, it has like their earlier mixtape feels, that lo-fi sound.
Drumwork, you know it's the brand. Created diamonds when niggas left me with coal in my hand. And I was like a Thanos, bitch, I got every stone in my hand.
That's tough.
Used to stand in front of that store with the pole and the lamp.
I love that third syllable.
And I ain't have to sell my soul to sell no records, nigga. I wrote some of the
yeah, they kept it real.
And shifted the culture, but I probably never get the credit, nigga. But part of me,
hey, you finna get the credit from this channel.
I never do. Cause if I'm already called the best ever, then shit was left to do. Why you think all my shit so electric when I step in booth? My team on Hitler 2, put the industry on notice. Hauling ass tape, Reject 2, then I was golden. Spent 200 of my own bread, giving back during COVID. Frontlines feeding families, niggas ain't
that's
even
fire.
Promoted.
That's fire. That's fire.
For the homeless, they post me getting arrested. But this
shit, dog, I'm finna stand up and clap, man. Bro, this is sick.
My nigga used to fill my glass up. The Henny pour, Jay got do say. Why my people still buying Henny for?
Why the nigga talking about me, man? Why are you talking about me? Bro, Henny is under attack, man. I ain't defending Henny. I'ma just drink it.
Don't confuse me, it's just another rap. I'm so much more than that. More than that.
Ooh.
I'm more than look, that. Look. Don't let them tell you one side of the story. It's so much more than that.
Man, so my mind is super analytical. So it's very rare that I'll get caught up in the content. I'm kind of content agnostic. I don't really care what you rap about as long as the rapping is good. And that's kind of why I focus so much on, you know, rhyme schemes, punches, wordplay, alliteration, all those technical sides of rap. But these last two songs have been so impactful. What he's rapping about is just so grand, so big. He's not even peeling back layers at this point. He's just like opening his chest. Just so much real stuff he talked about in that song. And like I said, the lyricism isn't taking a back seat. This is still very technically sound rapping. This is Channel Pearls.
Stay on my toes, the ones you love most wanna know what your safe really hold. No morals in the streets now, nigga break from the road. Put niggas in position, they still ungrateful, it shows. It's fucking up my energy, shit.
This is a sick four syllable rhyme scheme. He's been keeping it going for a minute.
Painting peaches, you got that shit on you, killing them, that's just saying the least. You about to get away with murder, you my Annalise. Got you to bust down Cardi, that's 30 bands at least. Chanel pearl, Chanel bag, hold that.
Bro, this man rapped for a minute and 30 seconds and he had three different rhymes. Only three. Like, that's how long he kept these rhyme scenes up. And one was a four, I think one was a three, and another was a four. Bro, that's rapping. That is rapping. You getting the content, you getting the personal cuts, but he's still delivering on the lyricism side of things. He's still rapping.
With our minds and sativa, I was your lady, your confidant, your sugar thighs.
Boy, he done upgraded. He went from Keisha Plum to Jill Scott.
So I never trip. Fuck the little girls that you hit, waiting for the change they might get. They wanted that. It was the rhymes that you spit, your confidence in the dick.
Man, you can tell the level of thought with how this album was crafted. I do appreciate the fact that these more personal and emotional cuts have brighter beats, and it keeps the album from like hitting a lull, not as far as like the quality of the songs, but just a lull emotionally. But yeah, man, this song was sick. Conway's verse, I went into why that verse was so good. Jill Scott's verse, that verse was okay, technically speaking. I think the thing about that verse is there's some novelty to it because you got Jill Scott on the Conway song and she's rapping. I mean, she would have been better if she was just singing, but, you know, it wasn't bad. It wasn't bad, I guess. It's better than Keisha Plum, I'll tell you that much. And speaking of Keisha Plum, this is Babas. Feeling the breeze while his blood stains the leaves. I hit him with a meat cleaver. You should leave her before you get 6 feet deeper. Keisha Plum, I'm killing you bums. Bro, these niggas gotta relax. Bro, these niggas gotta relax. Bro, who made this beat? The Usual Suspects, B Butcher and Derringer. This is sick.
Blood gurgling at the back of his throat. The smell of gunpowder suffocates his nose. Echoes of screams clinging to life.
Oh, this is so disorienting.
He will never leave. Came back like his prophecy. The night gets wet. Spontaneous shootouts. Niggas bring out the heat in the chilly buffalo
shit. Yo, this is not bad. This is not bad.
This is what happens when
that was actually pretty good. It wasn't what I did before the song came on. I might need to chop this and put it for the next Keisha Palm feature.
Sit more on stomach, that's mad stitches. Young mothers crack addictions. Young niggas, father never present.
Oh, he got a different flow.
Come home, back to prison. Bad decisions, bad position. Judges over sentence. That's the system, crack the system. Dirty cops, police stations, old cases, broke.
No mas. No mas. God, this song is too much.
Public schools underpaid, teachers miss education.
Bro, and his cadence is speeding up and slowing down when the beat changes tempo.
Look what I became. I went from king to a god.
Bro, it's not fair. It's not fair. It's not fair. The verse was amazing. The flow was amazing. And he did so much with so little. His bars were choppy, so he wasn't getting out that many words with each bar. But the imagery with what he did, it just put you right in. First, it just put you in the hood. And then it put you in his shoes as he navigates it. You know, he just took a series of scenes and tied a really nice bow on it when he said, "Look what I became, went from a king to a god." You know, obviously making reference to like, this is my background and this is what I made out of those bad circumstances. But then the really clever nod to one of his early albums, Look What I Became, and then his previous album before this, From King to a God. I'm telling you, man, if Derringer and B Butcher was playing a sport, they get drug tested. Niggas is on one. All right, man, this is God Don't Make Mistakes. I'm actually pretty pumped for this because people were saying this is the original name of this song was The Cow 2. I don't know if that's true or not, but let's see.
Sometimes I wonder.
Nah, I'm not ready. I'm not ready. I'm not ready. I'm not ready. I already see where this is going. Let me just take a second.
What if I went with Rocco that night? He had a show in Carolina. He like, bro, fuck with me. Let's do it right. What if I went? That shit would have changed a lot of events. But instead of going, I flew back to Buff to record with French. The song Driveway with my niggas and Lulu when I got hit. Everything happens for a reason, but I'm just saying what if. What if I never got shot in the head? I couldn't get sleep at night. Might drop a tear in that hospital bed. Thinking it's over with for rocking the mic. They told me I'll be paralyzed, neck down. What if the doctor was right? Was right? Nigga, I brother. In basketball terms, I pick and I roll. I give and I go. I get to the hole. Get the assist with my bros. I'm the one lifting the load.
Yep.
I do the scoring, nigga. I'm bringing the chip to my own machine.
Go ahead and set the parade up. It'll start on Doe Street and end on Montana Block.
All the raps and stuff that you wrote, it's cool.
Oh, that's his mom. That's dope. This is dope.
Please, give me my son back, boy.
Conway. Bro. Oh my. Well, let me talk about this song first before I talk about this entire album. There would have been no better way to end this album. The verse was amazing. I don't even have to tell you that the verse was amazing. The storytelling was phenomenal. And then all those questions that he posed at the end of the song. And then his mom at the end of the song. comparing it to The Cow, this song had just a completely different vibe than The Cow to me, because it just had such a positive outlook to it, even though he was talking about tragedy, really, and just seeing the good and everything that came with it. Overall, this was an amazing album. I'm one listen in, but I think we got a front runner for album of the year really early into the year. It'll be between this and Gold by Riggs, but the rapping was just phenomenal from start to finish, especially from Conway. The features that did appear here were fire for the most part. Lil Wayne's verse was insane. Jay Ski's verse was fire. Westside Gunn and Benny the Butcher, they had fire verses. But yeah, Conway was the star of the show here. He was at his absolute best when he came to his writing and his lyricisms. The rhyme schemes were excellent from start to finish, and his imagery was excellent from start to finish. He let his punching, which is normally a really strong strength for him, he let that take a back seat and really just bared it all emotionally. The most personal album by him, not even close, to date. The production on this thing was overall pretty amazing. I think Derringer was probably the star of this, between him or Alchemist. Hit Boy's beat was insane. B Butcher's as well. B Butcher, he co-produced some songs with Derringer that were insane. It's still early, but this is a top Griselda project. It's a top Griselda project because you can probably count them on one hand the number of albums that have better rapping than this. And none are as personal as this one. I thought very highly of From King to a God. This one might be a little bit better than From King to a God. Yeah, I don't know what else to say. This is great.